Macmillan Audio presents Acts of Violet by Margarita Montimore. Read for you by Brittany Pressley, Dan Bittner, Fred Berman, Katharine Chin, Ramon de Ocampo, Johnny Heller, Hilary Huber, Amy McFadden, Alejandro Ruiz, and Suzanne Toren. I didn't disappear. I was present for all of it. Britt Marling and Zal Botmanglich, the OA. Don't be the real you. Be the better you. Be the astonishing you. Be the you no one can ignore. Violet Volk, you are magic.
Strange Exits Podcast, Season 1, Vanishing Violet, Extended Trailer.
Anyone who tells you they knew Violet Volk is a liar. I was married to her, and I still couldn't tell you who the real Vivi was, because nothing was real with her. Her life, her career, it was all a series of illusions.
Violet was a strange one. Part gutter punk, part diva. She was unpredictable, whip smart, charismatic as hell. Not conventionally beautiful, but alluring in the way that self-assurance gives people a special magnetism.
There was this malleable quality to her. Sometimes Violet could be the most gorgeous woman you've ever seen, and other times, she was utterly hideous. Either way, it was impossible to take your eyes off her.
I worshipped her. I think a lot of girls in the 90s did.
She was a phony, and she made millions off people buying her lies.
Violet Volk was the greatest magician of our generation, arguably of all time. Her act was jaw-dropping, with illusions that defied explanation. Some even believed she was gifted with special abilities that extended beyond those of a skilled magician.
Nobody could do what she did. I don't know what you'd even call it. It was more than magic. There are tricks she performed that nobody's figured out to this day. All that stuff with fire and blood and levitation, it was mind-blowing. Deep down, you knew these things had a logical explanation, but sometimes you still felt like you were watching something miraculous. Violet Volk didn't perform magic. She was magic.
You know how many guys can do what she did? If Violet wasn't a sexy chick, we wouldn't even be talking about her.
Stage magic has always been a boys' club. Even today, over 90% of professional magicians are male. History has forgotten greats like Adelaide Herman, Del O'Dell, Celeste Evans, and Dorothy Dietrich, and relegated women to serving as little more than pretty props. Violet made a name for herself in this boys' club and showed us we can be more than pretty props, on stage and off. History will not forget Violet Volk.
A feminist icon? Give me a break. Less performance artist, more con artist, if you ask me.
Whether you loved or hated her, whether she inspired you or pushed your buttons, you have to give her credit for how provocative she was. Being neutral about Volk was not an option. You were bound to have a strong opinion.
Violet's biggest talent was knowing how to provoke attention. Some find that admirable. I think it's cheap and disgusting. Not worth the spotlight. Sorry if I sound bitter, but that bitch broke my heart.
She was a visionary, and like all visionaries, she faced her share of being misunderstood, judged, and criticized. That doesn't make her any less brilliant.
From her meteoric rise in stage magic and pivot to self-help guru, to her salacious romantic entanglements, to a muddy personal history filled with contradictions and obfuscations, Vivi was perennially complex and enigmatic. If there was one thing you could rely on her to deliver, it was the unexpected.
How could this have happened? There were so many witnesses, hundreds, thousands of us, and nobody saw a thing?
We all thought it was a giant publicity stunt at first, but as weeks passed, then months, now it's been almost 10 years. You gotta start to wonder if maybe we'll never see her again. Maybe she's not with us anymore.
I heard she was hiding out somewhere in the Amazon.
In the years since her mysterious disappearance, she continues to capture public curiosity and spark speculation. There have been various unconfirmed sightings of Volk, and countless theories persist around her vanishing.
I don't think she's dead. There were some unpleasant realities Vivi was about to face, and she was getting tired of her fame and notoriety. She had plenty of reasons to want to start a new life. Staging her disappearance would be the perfect way to do it.
Violet once told me, when you're rich and famous, you can get away with anything. You have no idea what I've gotten away with. The thing is, she looked scared when she said that.
There were people who had grown tired of her antics and felt threatened by her. I don't know how much more I can say. I wouldn't want those people coming after me.
We're never gonna know what really happened. Someone as clever as Violet? If she doesn't want to be found, she won't be.
I miss her every day, and I'll never stop looking for her.
She loves being a puzzle. She prides herself on it. Violet reveals different pieces of herself to different people, and nobody ever gets to see the full picture.
Join us on Strange Exits as we put together the pieces and try to solve the puzzle of Violet Volk. The Finchley Free Press. Vanishing Volk Causes Riot by Cameron Frank. February 24th, 2008. Friday night, 2,000 people packed the Witkin Theater in Willow Glen to see legendary magician Violet Volk perform her first stage show in years. People came from around the world to see Volk's act, with some paying over $1,000 per seat from resellers. They were expecting an extraordinary night. Little did they know they'd be witness to the last confirmed sighting of this mercurial performer. Violet Volk was one of the most popular stage magicians of the 1990s. Her numerous tours and television appearances, along with a residency in Las Vegas, making her a household name. In the early 2000s, she reinvented herself as a self-help author and toured the world as a motivational speaker. While she incorporated some effects into her seminars, questions persisted from fans and press alike as to whether she'd ever return to the stage as a full-fledged magician. It wasn't until early 2008 that they received a satisfying answer when Volk announced a special performance in her hometown of Willow Glen, New Jersey. One night only, but many believed a proper tour would follow. After Friday's show, nobody is sure what to believe. The performance was stripped down compared to her TV specials or Las Vegas show. Violet Volk unplugged, relatively speaking. There were no acrobats or dancers providing colorful misdirection, no screen projections, and apart from the final illusion, few pyrotechnics or elaborate set pieces. The restrained approach made Volk all the more astonishing to watch, and the audience was enraptured for a full hour until the Flaming Angel, one of her trademark disappearing acts. The effect proceeded smoothly until it was time for Volk to reappear. She never did. The confusion that ensued caused a stampede, with 29 people hospitalized for minor injuries. The Flaming Angel involved 4 hoops suspended 6 feet above the stage floor and lit on fire, followed by the magician, clad in a white bodysuit and matching angel wings, levitating and passing through them. While navigating the fourth hoop, her wings would burst into flame and she'd vanish in a puff of smoke and an explosion of feathers. Moments later, she'd reappear in a different part of the theater. Last night's iteration was entirely unprecedented. When the spotlight trained its beam on the upper balcony where it was supposed to find the performer, now wearing a supposedly charred black bodysuit and wings, it remained fixed on an empty space. A theater crew member who wished to remain anonymous said, "We rehearsed it dozens of times. When she didn't reappear, we were scared there was a tech malfunction. We checked the rigs and equipment, but saw nothing wrong. So we went all over the theater hoping we'd find her quickly enough that the audience would think it was part of the act." At first, they did. "Everybody was looking around trying to figure out where she'd reappear," said Nancy Martin, a fan who traveled from Vancouver for a front row seat to the spectacle. "But I knew something was off. I saw Violet perform dozens of times back in the day, and the way the stagehands were rushing around felt sloppy and panicked, not rehearsed at all. I could tell right away it wasn't part of the show." When Volk failed to reappear after a few minutes, the music was cut and the house lights came on. "You could hear a worried murmur go through the crowd," Martin said. "Then there was this announcement apologizing for technical difficulties and asking us to please remain in our seats. I got scared when I saw security guards walking down the aisle, and when the police showed up a few minutes later, I got really scared. Then somebody asked if there was an active shooter, and all hell broke loose. The manager of the theater called to report the disappearance," said Willow Glen Chief of Police Howard Donegan. "It happened during the show, so we were concerned about foul play and wanted everyone to stay put. If that theater was a crime scene, we needed to preserve it and keep track of everyone present. You're looking at hundreds of potential witnesses, and there's no telling if any might have been accomplices. But you also have to bear in mind, the whole thing could be a big stunt." Law enforcement couldn't confirm who initiated the panic that caused people to flee the theater. "I don't know what would have given someone the mistaken idea that we had an active shooter in our midst. One minute, everyone was sitting calmly in their seats. The next, it was a mob scene," said Chief Donegan. "We're lucky nobody was grievously injured." After the theater manager confirmed Volk's disappearance was not part of her show, officers and theater security officials searched the area. They have yet to find any trace of her. Volk's sister, Sasha Dwyer, was in the audience Friday night, appearing composed and only mildly concerned, stating, "Violet's been known to fall off the radar now and again. I have no idea what happened tonight, but I'm confident she'll turn up soon." Could she know more than she's letting on? Some audience members took a more cynical approach. "The whole thing was a setup to grab more headlines," said one man who preferred to remain anonymous. "No one generates publicity better than Violet Volk." A representative for the performer disputes the notion that her disappearance was staged. "Violet has deviated from the script before, which is what makes her such a compelling entertainer. But her vanishing is not a publicity stunt and is of serious concern to us. We urge the public to reach out if they have any information on her whereabouts." While police are unsure whether to treat this as a legitimate missing person case, they're erring on the side of caution. "She's a grown woman and has the right to go missing," said Chief Donegan. "That said, the circumstances surrounding this disappearance are unusual, and given Volk's high profile, we need to rule out foul play. If she went missing voluntarily, we ask that she notify law enforcement to let us know she's in no danger so we can focus our resources elsewhere. Otherwise, for the meantime, we'll keep looking."
EntertainmentWhenever.com. Violet Mania in Full Bloom by Reggie Moser. January 10, 2018. It's hard to believe nearly a decade has passed since Violet Volk disappeared, considering how her legend endures. Video clips of her magic routines and motivational talks continue to get millions of views online. Her signature alternate glam goth style still echoes in today's fashion trends, and her books periodically reappear on bestseller lists, her brand of inspirational tough love still resonant today. February 22 will mark 10 years since Volk's final performance and her mysterious vanishing. As this somber anniversary draws near, Vivi's absence will be felt more acutely than ever, and thousands are expected to flock to the annual candlelight vigil in Willow Glen, New Jersey. If you can't make it there, you'll have plenty of other opportunities to celebrate the magical performer. Here are some noteworthy Violet-centric projects to have on your radar. Hashtag Violet is back. This trending hashtag is accompanying posts of current photos that supposedly feature Violet Volk. Most are amusing impersonations, but some are striving for verisimilitude. This social media fad has seemingly come out of nowhere. Is it a marketing ploy? A sign of an imminent comeback? An organic outpouring of fan appreciation? Nobody can say for sure, but if we can't have the real thing, we'll take these wannabe Violets any day. Strange Exits, podcast, Sidecar Studios, January 23. Journalist Cameron Frank.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.